YouTube. Non, non, c'est pas ça. On va pas faire ça. Hello YouTube. Today we're going to talk about convergence and how to use it. So let's see. Let's start with defining few notions. Here, let's switch scene. Okay. So the first convergence, the one you will learn at first, is the simple convergence. You study f with a variable n, so it's a sequence, and it simply converges or just converges on interval I only if when n goes to plus infinite, it converges to f to another function f. And that's what we call simple convergence or just convergence. The uniform convergence, it's when UFN, we call UFN being uniform, having a uniform convergence to the function g on the interval I, only if the limit when n goes to plus infinite of the infinite norm on the interval I is zero with what we call the norm of the sup, also called the norm of uniform convergence because it's mainly used to demonstrate uniform convergence, being the superior element with x in the interval I. Of the absolute value of f to f function of x. So what it means is basically you take the highest, the biggest element on I, and you take the absolute value of the highest thingy. It can be something like that isn't reached. So yeah. And what it means is basically that, unlike the simple convergence, it means that the function will always converge to that other function on every point, while the simple convergence is just that convergence on the infinite. What else? Normal convergence. A sum of function normally converges on the interval I if the series sum of the infinite norm or norm of the sup of f is convergent, simply. And that's a third one that we actually use, but it's hard to like demonstrate. For the Yerkes convergence, we obviously the great thingy called the normal convergence that is on top of everything. So if you sum, if a sum of function normally converges, it implies two things. The sum of f converges absolutely and uniform absolutely converges. Because the absolute value means that it converges absolutely, and also it converges uniformly, and also uniform implies that if it converges absolutely uniformly, it means that it converges absolutely, and it means that everything or both. In no matter what sense you put in it, the sum of functions simply converges. So that's how you can like use a few convergence definitions, but actually that doesn't help us to like know how to use it, where to use it and stuff like that. And it's very important for one thing actually, for swapping operations on functions. So let's switch to Excel. Yeah, that works. Okay, I'm going to zoom in. Okay, so I made this. It's it's a spreadsheet with things to swap different characters. So you have the limit of the sequence, which is L of the sequence UN, when N goes to plus infinite. The sum of that sequence, the integral sign, the derivability, the derivability of order k, which means you iterate the fact that you derivate. So if something is derivable of order k, it means that you can derivate, that it's derivable k times, and then you take its derivative and you apply the same pattern again and again. Continuity, limit of the sequence, limit of the function at the extremity of the interval considered. Both are pretty much the same thing. The sum of the sequence again and the integral sign. So, yeah, and I also placed few letters to like help to write it very condensedly. So to swap the limit of the sequence in continuity, you just have to prove that there is uniform convergence, and then you can just swap and prove continuity. Then the sum of the sequence and the continuity, it's pretty the same. You have to prove that it's continuous and that it converges uniform. Integral sign, same. You have to prove that it's not the same. You have to prove its continuity, and another thing, that it's dominated. Okay, so dominations mean that on the whole considered interval, you can always find a function that is above it, meaning that it's dominated. So domination actually means a lot. It means that it doesn't go to plus infinite, minus infinite, that you don't have weird stuff and things like that. Plus continuity also tells us that there is no cut in the function, like there is nothing where the function does weird stuff. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So I put the expression, there exists a function. I took the liberty to write superior or equal to zero, but it means that the function var phi is always positive or equal to zero. But like, I shouldn't be able to write that the function is superior or equal to zero. I meant that it's superior or equal to zero on every of its definition interval. So for all x and for all t, we both in a considered interval, obviously. The absolute value of f, that is a function of x and t, is inferior to var phi of t. Okay, so then we have these few things, derivability and derivability of order k with continuity. Actually, these are pretty trivial, that there is no problem with that. You can do pretty much whatever you want. You can swap functions, swap derivability in continuity. There is absolutely no problem with that. Okay, now I'm going to talk about the theorem of the double limit. A sequence or a function at the extremity of the interval can be swapped with the limit of the sequence of the function if there is a convergence, a continuity, and uniform convergence. Then you can swap the limit of the sequence the limit of the function at the extremity of the interval with the sum of the sequence when there is convergence and uniform, when there is continuity and uniform convergence. Okay, now we are going to talk about Integral sign? Okay, so now it's getting serious because we are using integral sign. So we want to swap integral with the limit of the function at the extremity of the interval or the limit of the sequence. Okay, so there are two possibilities. Can either prove it by uniform convergence, or you can prove it that it's MC. So that's what in French is called continu par morceau, meaning that it's continuous but on few intervals. So you can either prove that it's that there is uniform convergence or MC and convergence simple and domination. If there are the three, you can prove it. Okay. Then for derivability, you have to prove that it's continuous and that the sequence of this derivative. So for example, if you consider the function f, you have to prove that the sequence of the f prime are uniform converges uniformly. Okay, and obviously that it's continuous. For the derivability of order k, you have to prove that the derivatives of order j with j inferior to k are continuous. So that means that if you want to prove that a function is derivable like a times, you will have to prove that the function is derivable of order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then you have to prove that what I wrote, dk seq is u, meaning that the derivative of order k sequence is uniformly convergent. So that's all. Okay, now let's talk about the sum of the sequence. Okay, so there is the thing we used earlier, the theorem of the double limit, applied to series. It's pretty much the same. You have to prove that it's uniform, that it converges uniform, and that it's continuous. It's pretty much the same. It uses same principle. Now we are going to talk about swapping the sum of the sequence with the sum of another sequence. So that's pretty much the same, because if you sum something and then you sum its sum, it's like summing the first time, but it's the sum. If you sum the sum of the first thing, it's the same thing as summing the first sum of that function, which means that you can swap them. Okay, so now let's talk about the integral sign and the sum of sequence. So you have two possibilities. Either the series converges uniformly, or you have to prove that it's continuous, that it converges simply, obviously, and that the sum of integral are absolutely dominated. Oh, yeah, that's a mistake. Because when you do domination, it's always absolute, because there are the absolute values. So it was a mistake on my document. So, the sum of integrals, obviously, are dominated, needs to be dominated to swap up the integrals. Then you have to... then let's talk about derivability and the sum of the sequence. So you have to prove that it's continuous and that the sum of the derivatives are uniforms. It's pretty much the same as the first column, like as we've seen that there is the theorem of the double limit, and the theorem of double limit for series, it's the same equivalent here, where we have the sequence of the derivatives needs to be uniform, and now it's the sum of the derivatives that needs to be uniformly convergent. Okay, for derivability. It's kind of more complex for derivability of order k. You have to prove that the sum, that each of the sum of the j derivative with j inferior to k are convergent, so c. And then you have to prove that the sum of the k derivative is uniformly convergent. It's kind of tricky, but it can be used, I guess. Now about the integral sign, you have again two possibilities. It's pretty much the same column as this one because you use the same theorem, but I'm just going to remind them. You have two possibilities. You can either prove the uniform convergence or prove that it's continue par morceau in French, or MC wrote continuity on parts, like continuity on small interval, sorry. That it converges and that it's dominate, that it is dominated. Then you have to if you want to swap the sum of the sequence with the integral sign, it's like something we've already seen, the integral sign and the sum of the sequence. It's actually the same, I just copy paste it. Oh yeah, so there is the same mistake here. So the series need to be uniformly convergent, or continuous convergent, and the sum of integral being derivated. Then the one of the only one with a mathematician's name, the theorem of Fubini, that says that basically if two functions are continuous on an interval, you can swap the interval, the integral sign. So yeah, okay. Now let's talk about the integral sign. Oh yeah, the integral sign and the derivability. So the derivatives need to be not absolutely dominated, but dominated, and that guarantees that the you can swap the derivability and the integral sign. And for the k order derivative, it needs to be dominated. Okay, so I guess we've summarized how convergences work and how to use them to swap few operations on functions and sequence of functions, series of functions, sums of functions, and things like that. So I guess thanks for watching and bye.